Today I am going to explain exercise 41. See the first question. Complete the series. Complete the series of equivalent fractions. So for them it is very new chapter. Okay, how to define equivalent fractions? For example, see this figure. So we have to shape this part. This is half, and in the same figure you can divide this into four parts, and two parts should be shaded. Okay, so this is 2 by 4. Observe the shaded part are same. So two fractions represent the same part. Those fractions are said to be equivalent fractions. How to find equivalent fractions? See, observe here, to multiply this with the numerator and denominator with 2 to get 2 by 4. Okay, see how to get the equivalent fractions. By multiplying or dividing the same number with the numerator and denominator of the given fraction to get an equivalent fractions. Okay, see, equivalent fractions means it represents the same part. And how to get the equivalent, how to obtain the equivalent fractions? By multiplying or dividing the same number with the non-zero number with numerator and denominator of the given fraction. See, after they given here 2 by 5, they are asking to write next three equivalent fractions. Here 2 2's 4, 5 is 10. Next 2 3's 5 3's, 2 4's 5 4's, 2 5's 5 5's. So what about 6 by 15, and next 8 by 20, and next 10 by 20. These are the equivalent fractions of the next three equivalent fractions of the given fraction. See the second one. Convert the following into mixed fractions. So mixed fractions means it is a combination of whole and proper fraction. Proper fraction means numerator is less than the denominator. A fraction in which numerator is less than the denominator is known as proper fraction. Like examples like this. These are all proper fractions. Improper fraction means numerator is greater than the denominator. Like this, 3 by 2, 5 by 4, like this. Mixed fraction. Mixed fraction means combination of whole and proper fraction. Whole and proper fraction. 1 1 by 2, 2 2 by 3, etc. These are all mixed fractions. Here the question is convert the following into mixed fractions. The given improper fraction, they are asking to convert the mixed fraction. 10 by 7. So you have to divide 10 with 7. 7 1 are 7 3. Now you have to write like this. 1 is whole part, remainder is the numerator part, and the division is the denominator part. 12 by 5. Divide 12 with 5. 5 2s are 10. Remainder is 2. Now whole part is 2, numerator is 2, and denominator is 1. Okay, you have to write down coefficient as whole part, remainder as numerator, and the divisor as the denominator. In that third problem, 29 by 4. So 4 29, 4 7s are 28, 1. So 7 1 by 4 7 1 by 4. See the next problem. Circle the proper fractions. See, proper fractions means numerator is less than the denominator. Here they give it some fractions. 6 by 13, 25 by 8. Clearly you have to observe which numerator is less than the denominator. See, observe it is less than, and here it is also, and it is also. So these are the proper fractions. fractions. This is third question, not fourth question. See the fourth one. Insert sign greater than, less than, or equal. First problem, 9 by 10, circle 2 by 5. 9 by 10, 2 by 5. So here after 9 by 10 and 2 by 5 are given, they are asking to compare which one is greater, which one is smaller. So in the case of different numerators and different, after they have to compare. Suppose if the denominators are same, which numerator is more, that fraction is greater. Suppose numerators are same, which denominator is smaller, that is greater. Other than in this case, we have to follow the cross products. 9 5. Here, this is not applied to both cases. That's why you should take cross products. 9 5s are 45, 10 2s are 20. 9 5s are 45, 10 2s are 20. So 45 is greater. So you have to write the sign 9 by 5 greater than 2 by 5. Other than the two cases, we have to find the cross products. Which cross product is greater? That fraction is greater. See the next one. 3 by 4, 10 by 11. 3 by 4, 10 by 11. 11 3s are 33. 10 4s are 40. So 40 is greater. So that implies 3 by 4 is less than 10 by 11. You have to keep the sign. Okay. 3 by 4 is less than 10 by 11. Okay. See the next problem. Write true or false. Write true or false. True or false. See, 8 by 16 is equal to 4 by 8 is equal to 1 by 2. See, observe here, 8 1s are 8, 8 2s are 16. 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8. So, all are equal. So, it is true. R are equal to 1 by 2. These are called equivalent fractions. See the 7th question. 1 by 2 of 150 units is equal to dash units. So half of 150, we have to divide this with 2 7s are 14, and remaining 1 is there, it is 10. 2 5s are 10, so it is 75 units. See the 8th question. 1 by 8 plus 3 by 8 plus 2 by 8. Here these are all like fractions. Like fractions means denominators are same. We have to write down denominators as same. What the denominator they given here and add the numerators. It is 7 by 8. In the case of like fractions, we have to write down the common denominator as denominator and add the numerators. Consider the next problem, 9th one. The LCM of 4, 5, 5 and 6. Least common multiple they are asking. Okay, na? For these three common multiples they are asking, so you have to do the process. Okay, 4, 5, 6. You have to select the table, it will go at least in two numbers. So 4 and 6 it will go into table. 2, 2 in 5, 5 won't go into table. You have to draw 5 as usual. See, 3 times. Here 2, 5, 3 are prime numbers, no table will go. So 2 into 5 into 3, it is 60. It is 60. See the 10th question. The cost of 4 erasers. The cost of 4 erasers is rupees 12. Is rupees 12. What is the cost of 9 erasers? What is the cost of 9 erasers. Here they given 4 erasers cost, they are asking to find 9 erasers cost. For that we have to find 1 eraser cost. Cost of 4 erasers is equal to rupees 12. So you have to find cost of one erasure. Cost of one erasure is equal to 12 divided by 4. 4 threes are. So one erasure cost is 3 rupees. But here they are asking to find 9 erasures cost. Cost of 9 erasures is equal to 3 rupees into 9, that is rupees 27. Okay, that is the method to find the 9 erasures cost. So today's class completed by you.